everyone's excited.
So
to this week, we're going to be talking about how your major can apply to the theme park world. Basically, everyone. From a business standpoint, you know, the one thing that every business has is a mission statement. So,
like, since it's not just big corporations that have them, even TBO has one. So our, as an organization, our mission statement is, the theme park organization, the group that is centered on a common passion for the theme park industry, while providing social networking and leadership opportunities for students. So I feel like that basically pretty much summarizes who we are as a group.
Mm-hmm.
Any other feedback you
No. I think we've done mission statements justice. Do y'all have any questions about that? What about different majors and how, I think it's pretty self-explanatory how you can get a business major in the theme park. It's about business, making money, regardless of what major.
Yeah, basically, like, I think the only one that I ever had a question on was what supply chain management was, and I've actually found out that was actually pretty cool. That's, like, the whole backstage process of getting a product developed and making it out to, like, on stage without anyone even ever seeing it.
Like, mechanical, they have a lot to do with, like, materials and manufacturing, as well as the, like, facility side. So they would do, like, the air conditioning kind of stuff and mechanical systems upkeep.
Next up, you've got civil. That's a really big one. That involves, who else here is civil? Yeah, we got quite a few civil. Civil is a lot of the structures, buildings, everything that stuff goes into, or on top of, or, you know, that sort of stuff. So you've got bridges, you've got hotels, you've got, you know, foundations, all that civil, and it's really important to keep a good foundation, I guess. All that sort of stuff. And that brings us to industrial as well. Industrial engineers, we've got a couple of those, I think. Yeah, so industrial is very important as well. Industrial is less building things and more dealing with how people and goods move around. So industrial will also be very involved in the layout of the park, guest flow, queue designs, some interesting facts like Disney World. The entrance to Tomorrowland is 2 times bigger than in the other entrances to lands because
what?
The industrial engineers found that most everyone's right-handed, so they go to the right first. Electrical and computer engineers are key to keeping the right systems running. That includes everything from websites for these businesses all the way to systems that will run the rides themselves. You need electrical inputs and prompts for these rides to run. Deals a lot with materials. Of course, you need to choose the best materials for these parks, whether that's metals, rubbers for different parts, any of that sort of stuff. Pyrotechnics, that's pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, and then so like there's also entertainment engineers, and they're like responsible for a lot of theatrical facilities and things like that.
Yeah.
So just to throw in some like cool things that engineers are responsible for in that area, Cirque du Soleil has the world's largest moving stage, and that was developed by engineers who had to find a way to make a stage move. And then not only that, but it's portable because Cirque du Soleil goes all around.
So as architecture and biz majors, we're typically the ones that are very responsible for immersing people in the story and the environment, creating that kind of like that topsy-turvy universe. Has anybody seen Wonderworks? Okay, wait, for those who don't know, Wonderworks is an upside-down house. So it's pretty amazing, especially by architectural standards, because we don't like our houses to be upside-down. But it immerses the... It immerses people in the environment that they want to belong into. When you have the... Sorry, my brain's a little foggy. In the steps of designing, does anybody know, like, that process in general? Like, what do you go through when you want to design something? Anybody?
Brainstorming first.
There you go. So, your concept. What are you initially doing? What do you want to do? The second step is to create a master plan. So you know what you're going for, you're gonna start evaluating everything, and then you're gonna start designing. So how is this immersing you in the experience? So what you have is your concept to your reality. So you've got your initial drawing of what you want this place to look like, and then you've got the final, which is pretty flippin' sweet. And when you go in there, you actually feel like you're in a giant Hershey's factory. Or when you're in Coca-Cola World, you feel like you're in a Coca-Cola factory. When you're in Disney, you feel like you're in like 50 different places. So, what, does anybody know what you have to consider when you're designing something?
Space constraints.
Very
budget.
Good.
Budget.
Budget's pretty important.
Timeline.
Does anybody know anything else that you have to consider?
Materials available.
It's a pretty good one. I'm thinking more along the lines of people have to pee.
Bathrooms, amenities.
Exactly. You have to focus on what are people going to be doing in this space. So if you have a hotel, you're not necessarily gonna go and make like a helicopter pad on top. Like that's more for a hospital or something else. Or you go and design a casino, you're not necessarily gonna have a pool. It completely depends on what you're designing.